Yeah.
Well, I mean, I'm not that good. So, I mean, I have wafers all over the place. So just take a look at your announcements. Things that we'll be doing different this morning. Offering of these couple ushers on the way out. You can give them the way in too, and the way out. And then we're going to do communion, and if you want to come up for communion, you may. If you choose not to, you choose not to. So we're just trying to provide worship for those that would like to be here. I know there's people that are not here that would like to be here, but we're taking it one Sunday at a time and seeing how things go. I know I just got an announcement on my phone that my daughter's school in a town of 700, they're canceling, and they're having school Monday, just so they can get all the laptops and everything like that ready, so kids are going to be going to school via internet, I guess. So don't be surprised if you start doing church via internet. That can happen too. So I would like at this moment to let us enjoy the prelude. Let us stand. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God who is present, who gives life, who calls into existence the things that do not exist. Amen. If you were to keep watch over sins, O Lord, who could stand? Yet with you forgiveness, and so we confess in silence. Gracious God, have mercy on us. We confess that we have turned away from you, knowingly and unknowingly. We have wandered from your resurrection life. We have strayed from your
thank you.
Last Wednesday, though, at Super Circle, we had 28 people, 27 people, I think, and we worked on four work groups. So if you're interested in looking into any of those and helping out with some of the work that has begun, I indicated in the newsletter that came out this morning who the people are who facilitated those conversations. Not that they are in charge of those teams, they simply are helping to coordinate those activities with the group of people that met with them last week. The Easter egg hunt is one of the things that's being organized for the Saturday before Easter. The stewardship drive, which will begin sometime in the next couple weeks and last through the year, with a couple of focus areas that are happening. A focus on the group looking into child care again. How can we get a child care facility at St. Mark's? The Navy currently is looking for partners for facility space, so we will pursue that. And the fourth group is on the river care, and how do we make sure that every member of St. Mark's is contacted on a regular basis and someone knows what's going on with them, that we can do a better job of creating a system to ensure that everyone is well and healthy and cared for at St. Mark's. So those are four areas: Easter egg hunt, stewardship, child care, and river care. If you'd like to know more about them, the person who is coordinating that conversation, or coordinated last Wednesday anyway, that information is in the newsletter. As Pastor Dan mentioned, the offering is at the door tonight. Today, we will be doing communion. You can take the wafer if you choose and not choose to dip it. You can choose to come and take the wafer and dip it if you choose, or you may choose not to take communion at all. We're giving you those options. We are recording today, our first time we're recording on Facebook Live on the St. Mark's website. So if for some reason you can be ill and are unable to come, we will continue to do that. We are also working today to see if we can get a podcast on GarageBand on the computer as well. So we're experimenting with that today to see if we can get a podcast. If that happens, there will be a link on the website. But we'll keep you informed as we figure these systems out to keep you in the loop, even if you're not in church. So in light of crazy times, and I have to tell you, we were back and forth probably 10 times over Thursday and Friday. Are we going forward with service today? Not going forward, are we canceling on and off? And when we got the churches canceled, we thought, well, maybe we should cancel, and we decided, all right, we're just going to come, and if you come, that's wonderful. If you choose not to come, that's okay. We'll try to find ways to make sure you can stay engaged with St. Mark's in other ways. So thank you for coming today. We appreciate your trust, and we believe God and the Holy Spirit is in the room with us and with those who didn't feel they could come today or not feeling well enough. God bless you all.
And for the men and women who will be protecting and helping in our community. May they, their families, and all others in need be wrapped in God's love and our prayers.
Good morning.
Reading from today, Exodus 17, verses 1 through 7. The whole Israelite community set out in the desert of Sin, traveling from place to place as the Lord commanded. They camped around them, and there was no water for the people to drink. So he formed Moses and said, "Give us water to drink." Moses replied, "Why are you quarreling with me? Why do you put the Lord to the test?" But the people were thirsty for water, and they grumbled against Moses. They said, "Why do you bring us out to Egypt to make us and our children and livestock die of thirst?" Then Moses cried out, "Lord, what am I to do to these people? They are almost ready to stone me." Lord answered Moses, "Walk in front of the people. Take with you some of the elders of Israel, and take in your hand the staff with which you struck the Nile, and go. I will stand there before you by the rock of Horeb. Strike the rock, and water will come up. I'll make all of you drink." So Moses did this in the sight of the elders of Israel. He called the place Messiah. the marathon, because of the Israelites forward, and because they test the Lord, saying, is the Lord among us or not?
Jerusalem. You Samaritans worship what you do not know,
We worship what we do know, for salvation is from the Jews. And yet, a time is coming, and has come, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for they are the kind of worshipers the Father seeks. God is spirit, and his worshipers must worship in the spirit and in the truth. The woman said, I know that Messiah, called Christ, is coming. When he comes, he will explain everything to us. And Jesus declared, I am. I am the one speaking to you, and he. Just then the disciples returned and were surprised to find him talking with a woman, but no one asked, what do you want, or what are you talking with? Why are you talking with her? Then leaving her water jar, the woman went back to town and said to the people, come, see, a man who told me everything I did. Could this be the Messiah? They came out of town and made their way toward him. Meanwhile, his disciples urged him, Rabbi, eat something. But Jesus said to them, I have food to eat that you know nothing about. The disciples said to each other, could someone have brought him food? My food, said Jesus, is to do the will of him who sent me, and to finish that work. Don't you have a saying, it's still 4 months until harvest? I tell you, open your eyes, look at the fields, they are ripe for harvest. Even now, the one who reaps draws a wage, and a harvest, a crop of eternal life. So the sower and the reaper may be glad together. And thus saying, one sows, another reaps, is true. I sent you to reap what you have not worked for. Others have done the hard work, and you have reaped the benefits of their labor. Many of the Samaritans from the town believed in him because of the woman's testimony. He told me everything I ever did. And so when the Samaritans came to him, they urged him to stay with them. And he stayed 2 days. And because of his words, many more became believers. They said to the woman, we no longer believe just because of what you said now. Now we have heard for ourselves. And we know this man really is the Savior of the world. Here he is. Father, open our hearts, our souls, and our minds, and may your word speak to us. Amen. He didn't have to go into the Samaritan area, but he chose to. And the way the Jews treated Samaritans, do you think they treated Samaritans nicely? No. They were considered less than dogs. Sometimes derogatory terms they would come up with towards the Samaritans. What happened with the Samaritans really is it ended up being a mixed race. When they came back out of exile, they were intermixed with the Assyrians and so forth. And so were not looked at as being pure Jews. But some lesson. Well, Jesus goes in. It's noon time, and mind you, people don't go to the well at noon time. It's really hot. For some reason, this woman is going because maybe she's dealing with issues. Maybe she's dealing with, I mean, five husbands. Really? Is she? What was it? Elizabeth Taylor? I think she had 8, right? Yeah. I was having 5 right here. Okay, 8. But, I mean, so she's going out at noon, so probably she's dealing with some shame. And trust me, small communities have a way of making you feel good shame. Or bad shame, I don't know. It doesn't take much. you don't want to be ashamed. So you'll do everything possible in the world. You even go at noontime to the well when other people are not there. What happened in her life? Did her husband die off? Did she just decide to divorce? What? I don't know. But Jesus chooses to speak with her, which no one would speak with, nor be seen with. I mean, the disciples came back and saw what he was doing. They actually were appalled. They couldn't believe what he's doing. And in the conversation, she's amazed that he is talking with her. You are a Jew. You're not supposed to be talking to me. You're not supposed to be asking me for water. And then eventually we get in a conversation where she asks a very simple question. She says, you Jews worship in Jerusalem, but we worship here on this mountain. What she's asking is, where is God? Where is God in Jerusalem, or is God here? Is God at first Lutheran, or is God here? Is God at the rock? It's kind of like that situation. Where is God? And for her, where is God in my situation, and how does Jesus respond? I am. What do you think that means when he says, I am? Where have you heard that before? In the Old Testament? This is the first time in the Gospels that he makes I am. Meaning, where's God? I'm here. I'm here with you at the well at noontime. I'm at the well with you at noontime, and I'm listening to you, and I'm giving you hope. Because I am God. I am He, the Messiah. You know what the first people that probably was a missionary or a witness was that Samaritan woman? Because what does she do? She runs back to town. She goes that way. Oh, that way. Okay. Maybe some of you go away right now. She ends up going back and saying, look, this guy knows everything about me. And he's a Jew, and he even talked to me, and he told me everything about my life, which is not really so pretty. But still, he didn't abandon me or leave me, but kept talking to me. And then guess what? He said he was God, the Messiah. So when the disciples come back and Jesus starts talking about this harvest that they did not plant, who planted it? The Samaritan woman planted it. And the Samaritans started coming out in droves to Jesus. I can't imagine what the disciples were thinking. Oh, wow. I didn't know God meant for them to be saved, too. I mean, they're worse than dogs. Why would God want them? But God did, and God was present. These days, we are asking, where is God? You're hearing from one person to another. You're hearing on the news. Whether they're saying the words exactly like that, but where is our help coming from? Who's going to help us? Who's going to be here? Who? Where? God, where are you? Do you know where God is? He's in you. He's in you. He's in every one of you. Luther said that we are little Christs. That when we go out to people, we go out as Christ to people. And so we are Christ's hands, Christ's ears, Christ's mouth. And when we go out with the presence of God in our life, guess what we bring to each other? The presence of God. During the plague, was it 1917, 1918? Someone told me 57,000 died. But it wasn't all because of the plague. What it was is hospitals closed doors completely. Families were shunned. Deliveries were cut down. Kept people from getting food. And children with whole households were hungry, and parents didn't work, children would die of starvation. I've heard 57,000 die, I've heard 67,000 die. So what are we called to do now in amongst this situation? To go, be, listen, provide for, be the presence of Christ amongst the chaos. Be that one person of peace and love and care. Be Christ. There's a good article I'm going to share that actually talks about how the plagues are and how the plagues were being dealt with and why the death level and stuff like that. And they said what they're doing right now, like say in Washington, up in Washington, that you have doctors coming to work. You have nurses calling in saying, I'm willing to work rather than hiding. And so, let us be there for one another. Father, help us. Thank you for your love and your care.
Thank you.
Please bow your heads. Join me in prayer for the people. Turning our hearts to God, who is gracious and merciful, we pray for the church, the world, and for all those in need. God of living water, send your church down the boundaries to proclaim your grace. May it witness be the source of oppression and thirsty souls. Strengthen our voices, that all people can know and believe that Jesus is truly the Savior of the world. God, in mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of living water, protect from pollution and misuse all rivers, lakes, oceans, and streams. Bless the work of those who dig wells and those who advocate for access to clean water to all people and animals. God, in your mercy.
Hear
our prayer. God, in your water, open our hearts as we open the hearts of leaders and authorities, that they hear the cries of suffering and act with compassion toward them. Bring peace to disputed lands and bring reconciliation to the people divided by race, culture, or nationality. God, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of living water, mend the hearts of those who grieve broken relationships, whether by conflict, abuse, divorce, or death. Draw near to all who are ill. Assure those questioning your presence in the midst of doubt or suffering. This morning we pray especially for Dottie Grimes, Jennifer Alcon, Chris Ferguson, Don Alou, Vicky Scotland, Sandy and the Bushfield family at the death of Tom, and for all those who serve our community. God, in your mercy. Other prayers we offer at this time for the Father's side. God of living water, renew us in the promises of baptism. Join us together in worship, fellowship, and sharing your good news. Embolden us to serve others and work for justice and peace. God in your mercy. God of living water, thank you for those who endured suffering and for who now boast in the glory of God. Pour your Holy Spirit into our hearts and give us peace that we live in our hope and our salvation according to your steadfast love. O God, hear these and all our prayers as we commend them to you through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us go right to offertory response. Accept the Lord the gifts we bring. Place upon your table. We do not worship as we ought, but only as we are able. On the night in which Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and he gave thanks and he broke it. And he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you." Again, after supper, the Lord Jesus took the cup, gave thanks, gave it to all of them, saying, "This cup is the cup of my blood shed for you and for all the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us together pray the Lord's Prayer. Our come now, the meal prepared for you. Now receiving the communion moment. Now may the body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you, keeping God's grace now and forever. Amen. Receive the blessing. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. saying, joyful, joyful, we adore you. Say it in for you.
Thank you.